Wow. Tonight, I just watched the worst pay-per-view tonight. The worst. Worst pay-per-view I've freaking watched in my life tonight at fake Money in the Bank. Fake freaking Money in the Bank. This doesn't make any freaking sense. I'll be damned. I'll be very damned. Let me just tell you what happened tonight. The show kicked off tonight with the women's Money in the Bank championship match contract for, you know, the Money in the Bank ladder match for a women's championship contract, either the Raw women's title or the SmackDown women's title. Participants were Liv Morgan, Alexa Bliss, Asuka, Becky Lynch, Lacey Evans, Raquel Rodriguez, Shotzi, and Liv Morgan. And what happens tonight? What happened? What I just saw? I just saw Liv Morgan. Liv Morgan win. Becoming the 2022 Women's Money in the Bank winner. Money 2022 Women's Money in the Bank ladder match winner. What happens? What does WWE do tonight? Once again tonight they shit over Becky Lynch. Again. I mean, this is the same shit that happened to her at Money in the Bank 2018. I mean, WWE, you let Alexa Bliss, do it to her at Money in the Bank 2018. You let Alexa Bliss do it to Becky Lynch at Money in the Bank 2018, having Alexa Bliss knock Becky Lynch off the ladder, and for Alexa Bliss to climb up the ladder, and grab that briefcase. And tonight, you do the same shit to Becky Lynch again by having Liv Morgan climb up that ladder and take that briefcase for her briefcase to win. Once again, WWE, you shit over Becky Lynch again. I mean, I thought Lacey Evans was gonna win this match. I expected Lacey Evans to win and come to 2022 Women's Money in the Bank ladder match winner. Cause she can win it to honor and support of the 4th of July weekend, despite her being a U.S. soldier in honor of our great country, the United States of America. But once again tonight, they shit over Becky Lynch. She has never in her freaking life has won never in her fucking life, she has never, ever, 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 as Chris Jericho used to say, ever won women's Money in the Bank winner. What you do, WWE, you shit on her again tonight. You shit on her at Money in the Bank 2018 about like 4 years ago. Now 4 years later tonight, you do it to her tonight again at Money in the Bank 2022. Somebody disagreed with me I said to myself that Liv Morgan has really lived her dream tonight, but someone had to disagree with me tonight because they shit on Becky Lynch and Liv Morgan stole Becky Lynch's dreams away tonight. But let me get to a next one that I like tonight. The only thing I like tonight at Fake Money in the Bank was Bobby Lashley shutting up Austin Theory and went back giving him the United States title tonight. That pain in the ass asshole Austin Theory. I'm glad Bobby's shutting him up, but I'm gonna get to Austin Theory. I'm gonna deal with that. I'm gonna get to Austin Theory in a little bit, in a few minutes later. But congratulations, but Bobby Lashley finally shut him up and got won the United States title and finally shut Austin Theory's ass up tonight. He's shutting him up, man. Shut his ass up. Finally, he shut him up. And now let me get to the next one. The Raw Women's Title match, Bianca Belair versus Carmella. Yeah, Bianca Belair retains her Raw Women's title. But what happens then? Carmella becomes a sore loser, attacking Bianca Belair. Yeah, Carmella. I bet your dipshit husband. Corey Graves, or should I say Matthew Blinsky must be really proud of you. Matthew must be really proud of you, aren't you? What you've done to Bianca tonight, haven't you? How about if your husband shuts up and you shut up as well? How about if you shut the fuck up, and how about if your husband shuts the fuck up? For once. You don't deserve, you're not championship material, Carmella. I mean, or should I say Leia? You're not championship material. Because when your father came to WWE, when it's called the World Wrestling Federation, the WWF, he had no title. He had no championship title. He was just a jobber. So why? I don't know why you came to the WWE. I don't know why you came to the WWE. I mean, you were like some cheerleader and shit. And I don't know why you came to the WWE. When your father was only a jobber and never had a championship title. I mean, he was never a Dusty Rose. He was never a Ric Flair. He was never any other kind of wrestling legend. Your father was a jobber. He had no title run, and he had no title or no championship, and you don't deserve to be women's champion. You're overrated as fuck, and you don't deserve to be women's champion. You're overrated, and your father was just a jobber. Paul Van Dale. Paul Van Dale, your father. Slut. God, this is a real terrible. Now let me get to a next one that makes me wanna be really furious about. The Usos beating the Street Profits for the Undisputed Tag Team Championship match. And who wins? Bam, the Usos. Once again, the Usos win again. Tonight, they really shit over the Street Profits. So way to go, Vince, Bruce. You really shit on the Street Profits and let the Usos get all the fucking spotlight tonight. All the fucking spotlight. Nicely well done. Bravo. Raw fucking O. Motherfuckers. Raw fucking O. All y'all are some. I'm telling y'all. Bruce Prichard, Vince. Dunn. All y'all are some amazing motherfuckers. Amazing motherfuckers. Amazing mofos. Oh boy. You really shit on the Street Profits. I mean, Street Profits should just quit WWE, man. Should just quit WWE because they don't know what to do. WWE don't know what to do with the Street Profits, man. They did not get the smoke tonight. They did not get the fucking smoke tonight, the Street Profits. Now let me get to a next one. A next one that I ain't. That I'm happy about. I'm really happy Ronda Rousey won by Natalya by submission. But what happens then after Ronda Rousey beat Natalya? Who comes in? Who cashes in her Money in the Bank? Liv Morgan on Ronda Rousey. Now I said and I said to myself that she lived a dream and she deserved it. She finally became the SmackDown Women's Champion. But someone disagreed with me because it was bad fucking timing for Liv Morgan to cash in. Liv Morgan should just wait until like a few days or months to cash in. But what'd she do? She was stupid enough to cash in tonight. She could've just waited until like a few days or months to cash in tonight. But what did she do? She had to cash in tonight. But I said to myself, but I never saw it coming. I never saw it coming tonight that she was gonna cash in. I never saw it coming. I'm not gonna lie. I never saw it coming. I didn't expect she was gonna cash in tonight. I almost thought she was gonna like wait until like for a few days or months to cash in. I thought she might go after Bianca's Raw Women's title, or maybe probably Ronda Rousey's SmackDown Women's title. But you know, but the only thing I saw tonight, Ronda Rousey did was she passed the torch to Liv Morgan. She passed the torch and showed sportsmanship. And Ronda Rousey was a great loser. That was class. Good sportsmanship. But Liv Morgan should have just waited. She should have just waited until days and months to cash in. Days and months, or a day, like a few days to cash in. That's all she should have did. Just wait. But she had to cash in tonight. Now, I'm going to get to the next one. The main event. The Money in the Bank ladder match for a World Heavyweight Championship match. Contract. Seth, piece of shit, freaking Rollins, Sheamus, Sami Zayn, Riddle, almost Madcap Moss, pain in the asshole, Austin Theory, and Drew McIntyre. And who wins? Who wins the 2022 becomes the 2022 men's Money in the Bank winner? Pain in the ass, Austin Theory. Wow, the eighth entry. Theory, what are you? What are you, Theory? Are you Vince's little beck and call? Are you on Vince's payroll? Where are you? Huh? You really love sucking the grapefruits of that old bastard Vince McMahon, aren't you, Austin Theory? You really do like sucking the grapefruits of that old bastard Vince. Why WWE? Why would you let this pain in the ass Theory become the Money in the Bank winner tonight? The 2022 men's Money in the Bank ladder match winner. This is really looking terrible for WWE. Really looking terrible. You know what's gonna happen? Maybe sometime like on July 30th, maybe like, I mean, we all know that he did it. We all, it just been announced that that Roman Reigns and Brock Lesnar will face each other at SummerSlam 2020 SummerSlam 2022. We're undisputed for both titles. For both titles, the WWE title and the Universal title, both titles, the unified title, the unified WWE titles, both the WWE title and the Universal title. We all know what's going to happen at SummerSlam 2022 on July 30th in Nashville this year. Theory. You're gonna fail to become the unified champion. You're gonna fail having both titles. You're gonna fail taking both titles from Roman, the WWE title and Theory. You're weak. You cannot stop Roman. You cannot stop Roman. The man is bulletproof. And I don't know why WWE let Austin Theory win this match. I mean, let win this ladder match tonight. Austin Theory is gonna fail miserably. He is gonna fail cashing in on Roman. This is why. It was the stupidest booking I've ever seen tonight in my life. It was the stupidest booking tonight at Fake Money in the Bank. Fake Money in the Bank. This was very terrible. This is not looking good. I mean, thank God. I mean, I really do hope. I mean, this is really, I mean, terrible pay-per-view. Austin Theory will fail cashing in on Roman in the main event between Lesnar and Roman. He's gonna fail cashing in on Roman. This is why it's not looking good for WWE, because y'all are gonna lose to AEW. We all know Stephanie McMahon probably might do something like riding their father Vince's coattails and make some bad changes and shit. But since she's the new CEO of WWE, but Vince is still in charge a little bit. But still, it still has the same booking. Who knows if Stephanie McMahon, the new CEO, will come up with something. Who knows if she'll make changes and stuff like that. But Vince McMahon is still in trouble with his sexual harassment thing. And I hope he's guilty of everything. Guilty of sexual harassment, because I know he's guilty. He's guilty. I hope he goes to jail. The Stephanie McMahon be in charge. And make changes and maybe WWE might do something to give the fans do the right thing, make better booking like it was before. But who knows? I mean, who knows? This was a shitty show tonight. Very shitty show. We all know the next pay-per-view, Summer Scam, on July 3rd is going to look very shitty. But in tonight's pay-per-view, Fake Money in the Bank looked very shitty. It's garbage tonight. It's pure freaking garbage. It's unbelievable. WWE is going to fail. But I don't think it probably might fail since new CEO Stephanie McMahon. Since we have a new CEO named Stephanie McMahon. But I'm still liking AEW. Look, alright. I'm still liking the AEW. Austin Theory does not deserve to be champion. He does not deserve to be champion. Almost should have won this match. And Riddle should have won this match. I mean, why shit all over Riddle tonight in his own hometown? His own hometown, a lot of Las Vegas, Nevada. Total disrespect. He did the Vince did the Austin Theory in his own hometown. He really got screwed. He really got screwed. Vince put the screws to Austin Theory, put the screws to Riddle tonight, and let Austin Theory get shoved down our fucking throats. Vince, I really hope your time has come. I know that you're not gonna get. I hope that you're guilty of the sexual harassment thing, because you're not gonna get away with this just like you did with the steroid scandal in 1994. I hope you lose, Vince. I hope you're guilty. Your daughter will definitely be CEO of Power, and I hope he'll make sure that you do the right thing, make some changes for the fans. And I hope that she'll get rid of get a new creative team and give the fans what they want. But we all know that she's gonna ride in your coattails like she always does. But we'll wait and see. All I can say, this is a terrible pay-per-view tonight. Fake Money in the Bank 2022. Terrible pay-per-view. They really shitted on Riddle tonight in his own fucking hometown of Las Vegas, the City of Lights. Oh boy. So that's all I have to say for all of you tonight here at tonight about tonight's pay-per-view, Fake Money in the Bank 2022. And the Godfather of Soul, Justin Lewis Swimming. Hit like, make a comment on my video. I know some of you are hearing that song that I'm playing right now. The name of the song that you're hearing right now is called by For the Love of Money, the 70s song by the OJs. Yeah, it's called For the Love of Money. I love that song. One of the best soul songs in the 1970s. So that's all I would say. I'm the Godfather of Soul, Justin Lewis Fleming. Hit like, make a comment on the video. Subscribe to Justin Fleming. I hope all of you have a good 4th of July. Enjoy the food, all the hamburgers, hot dogs, the brats, the baked beans. And God bless America. Subscribe me. I'm Godfather Soldier Smooth Swimming. Hope all of you have a good night. Peace. I'm out of here.